NiNteNnDo!
Welcome everyone to NiNteNnDo Game Talk. My name is Coloco, and today's topic will be about NiNteNnDo INdIEs and all the recent fuss and complaining about these games. I wasn't even going to make a video about it, honestly. I wasn't going to even putting too much thought into all the complaining that's going on, because everybody complains about everything these days. Gamers could get everything that they want, and yet you still find a ton of loud people that complain about certain things. But because of the volume of people complaining about it, and because of the volume of videos of YouTube people from our community making videos about, you know, is there too many INdIEs right now on the Switch? I feel like I need to voice my opinion and just call out all those people and just say, all of you are just off. You're all not being truthful to the situation. You guys are all overreacting, because that's the way, sadly, that is our society nowadays. Overreact to every single thing, including something that's supposed to just bring us joy and is supposed to serve as entertainment for us, and you know, supposed to be a happy thing for us. Including that, they have to blow it up and try to bring some negativity and spin some negativity to it, because without that, you won't get the clicks, right? So let me begin by saying, first and foremost, that NiNteNnDo made it very clear that the NiNteNnDo Switch was going to have a lot of INdIEs. INdIEs were going to be a big part of the NiNteNnDo Switch's library from the get-go. From the get-go, they said that. So for the people saying that there's too many INdIEs on the NiNteNnDo Switch, first of all, that if you really think that, oh, I bought a NiNteNnDo Switch and what's up with all these INdie games? What's going on? Well, maybe you should have paid more attention and did a little more research before you bought a product that was, $300. So there's that. Now, I understand there are some legitimate concerns with having too many INdIEs. And the concerns are that, you know, you just don't have time for them. And that's okay. You don't have time. You're not supposed to have time to play every single game that comes out on a system. And if you do, I don't think you have a life if you have that much time to play every single game that's on any system. You know, maybe if you had a Wii U, you could definitely play every single game that was on that system. All jokes aside, you still couldn't. You really can't. You can't play even all the INdIEs on the Switch. You might be able to play the best ones that, in your opinion, the ones that, you know, call your attention. But that's the beauty of having such a big library to choose from. You know, not every INdie game is made equally. There's some that have different animations, different styles, that do things differently. You know, that goes hand in hand with the whole, oh, all INdies are the same. No, they're not. All INdies look the same. Why? Because they have pixel art? That doesn't mean anything. Are you trying to tell me every Super Nintendo game looked the same? Because they were all 16-bit. So that doesn't matter. Whether or not they're 16-bits, whether or not they're low poly, whatever you want to call it, they're all made by different artists. Each game is different. Yes, it is. I mean, that's just the same. Oh, every book looks the same. Why am I going to read books? They all have words. No, you have to look past that and see that they all are actually different and unique. Most of them anyway, like 99% of them. Or maybe the concern is that because there's so many releasing, that they'll be lost in the shuffle. I really don't think so. If you are that concerned, you basically are on top of all the great releases coming out. There are resources like Metacritic and OpenCritic that can tell you whether a game is worthwhile or not. It's funny to me that a lot of people are complaining, oh, there's not great games. What's all these little indie games nobody knows about? When game like Into the Breach was hit with that last NiNteNnDo INdie presentation, that was the last hit, right? And it seemed, it boggled my mind, because it seemed like all these major YouTubers that they are in the business, they're up and they know about things, they were totally clueless to what Into the Breach was. I mean, granted, I'll be honest, when I saw it, I said, oh crap, it's that game. I didn't know the name, but I know what Into the Breach was. I've heard of it. I've heard people just talking about it this year. It's the largest, it's the probably most talked about indie title on PC this year. And yet, most people are just completely oblivious to it. Because why? Do they, in that case, do they really look at what's coming out? Do they, are they really interested in you know, in what's going on? Because if you really are interested in these indie games that are coming out, in any game that's coming out, you would think that you would know about something so big like Into the Breach releasing on Switch. There's a reason why Nintendo held that for the last, because they usually hold the best surprises for the last, and that was a pretty big surprise. And it seemed like nobody talked about it. I thought that was kind of funny. And then at the same time, they go, well, that presentation was kind of weak. Well, that it's an indie presentation, right? So it wasn't, what were you expecting? There was not going to be any large AAA game on there. But on top of that, you know, the game that everybody was talking about as far as the PC world goes, when it comes to indie games this year, you're completely oblivious, and then you turn around and go, what was that about? And there was nothing there. So you're not appreciating the really big games, the games that are talked about. You're just kind of glossing them over and just kind of raking them all in the same bunch, because you're not looking at each game. You're just kind of like glossing over it. And I feel that this is a problem of when someone is too close to something, they can't see the bigger picture. So when we talk about YouTubers that you know, they have their full-time job is to review games. So they're constantly playing game after game after game. And if they're focused mostly on the Switch and they've played game after game after game, and a lot of those games have been indie titles, they're not seeing the bigger picture here. When the regular person, 99% of everyone else, hasn't been able to catch up with these large games. And the proof of that is that what is the top selling game still on the Nintendo Switch? You still got Legend of Zelda selling. You still got Mario Kart 8 Deluxe selling. You still got Odyssey selling, because people haven't been able to play these games. There's been a lot of volume in the past, 16 months or so, whatever it is right now. I just said it off the top of my head. I'm not sure. Whatever it is, right? You know, it's been a lot of volume of games that the regular person, the regular Joe, cannot get to all these games. So the fact that, you know, you have these hardcore people playing everything and anything that comes out, and then saying, well, there's nothing. While at the same time overlooking these great indie games, it's setting up a false narrative that the Switch has no games, or that Nintendo doesn't have the content for Switch owners. When if you look at any history of any console that's been out, and you look at the first 2 years, or whatever, the first year and a half of the Switch, it doesn't even come close. The Switch has blown everything out of the water in its first year and a half than any other system, if you look at it. I mean, even look at the 3DS. The Switch is about to overtake the 3DS in games. The 3DS has been out, 8 years? 7 years? Something like that? Something crazy? And the Switch is about to overtake the number of games available to it in a year and a half. And yet people say that there are no games, that there's too many indie titles flooding the market. And all while this is going on, we are still coming up on the two largest games of the Nintendo Switch's first party titles. And might be the two largest games yet. That's saying a lot with Legend of Zelda Mario and Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. And that is Pokemon and Smash. And that's just coming up in a few months. But yet people are so impatient. What are you doing with your time? I want to ask, what are you doing that you have played everything that the Switch has to offer? You don't want to look at these indies. And yet what are you doing with your time? I've seen so many people, I sold my Switch. Okay, buddy, sure, fine. If you sold your Switch, it's because you probably needed the money for something else. Don't try to say it's because, oh, I'm done with it. I'm done with the Switch. No, don't try to say that. You probably need the money to pay your bills or something. Because there's absolutely no way that you invest $300 in a system. You get games, specifically Nintendo system. You get games like Mario, Zelda in the first year. And then you're telling me you just kind of gave up? Especially knowing that new Metroid, new Pokemon, and a new Smash is coming out pretty soon. Nah, I don't buy it. Either A, you weren't a Nintendo fan to begin with. You got the Switch as a gift. I mean, there's a lot of circumstances involved with all these people saying that they sold their Switches. But I don't believe for a second that you're an actual Nintendo fan, that you read up on what the Switch was, that you bought it, that you played these games, and then you said, "What? A few indie games? No, that's it. I'm done. No, I don't buy it. And like I said, I don't buy anybody saying this stuff. That they're done with Nintendo because of these indie games. That these indie games are ruining the Switch. All you have to do is look at the eShop chart. That's all you gotta do. Are people burnt on indie games? Too many indie games? Look at the eShop chart. Are people buying indie games? Oh, look, yeah, they're buying it. That's all you need to know. That's it. People like indie games. People are buying them. Keep the indie games coming. Can we use something on the eShop that will categorize them better? Yeah, we can. But again, you have Google. Everybody has Google. Metacritic, OpenCritic are great resources. Find out what good games are. Buy them. Play them. That's it. And just wait for the other games coming out. They're coming. In the meantime, we got games like Wise 8 that came out. Nope. Did anybody say anything about that? We got Octopath Traveler coming out. That was a game that just released. There's all these great games coming out for the Switch, and on top of that, we got big games coming out in just a few months, but people are so impatient. They just want to try to make drama and clicks, and it's just leaving a negative stigma when everybody most people are just enjoying their Switch and just trying to have a good time. So, anyways, that's my thought on this Nintendo Indies. Are there too many? What do you guys think? Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? Let me know what you guys think about it. And if I'm wrong or right or whatever, I don't care. Let me know. Call me a jerk. Just don't call me late for dinner. I'm sorry. This is Nintendo Game Talk. Later.